Hi everyone. So today in this video we are going to continue the chapter, the fundamental unit. So activity 5.2. So here we can try preparing temporary mounds of leaf peels, tip of roots of onion, or even peels of onion of different sizes. So here mound is nothing but what? So have you remember in the previous video what we did? We have taken the onion peel, right? We have taken onion peel and we have taken a small piece of epidermis, that is nothing but the outer skin, and we have taken that piece on the slide and we have covered with the cover slip and we have observed this thing under the microscope, right? And we have observed the onion cells, right? Have you remembered? So this process we are going to call it as what? Mounting. We are going to call this process as mounting. So by using the same method, we can see the cells of leaf peel and the tip of root. So tip of root is nothing but, so you know the roots, right? So this is the tip of the root. You are going to take some section and you have to cut it. A small piece of the root, you are going to take it and you have to, by using the same procedure, you have to take slide, keep the tip of the root here, cover it with the cover slip and you have to observe under the microscope. So you can do this thing or this mounting process for the various things like leaf peel, tip of the root, or onion peels of different sizes. So you know that onions are of different sizes, right? You can see the cells of these things. So after performing the activity, let us see what the answers of the following questions would be. So first here, do all cells look alike in terms of shape and size, they are asking. So all cells are going to look same in shape and size? No. So cells will be different for leaf, different for root, and different for other things, right? So next, do all cells look alike in structure, they are saying. So structure is nothing but, we have seen in onion peel cell, we have seen the hexagonal cells, right? Hexagonal is nothing but six-sided cells, okay? So, and if you observe in other things, you are going to see round cells, okay? And round cells or rectangular cells or square-shaped cells, you are going to see in different structures. So, cells are of different structures. So, cells will be of different structure. They will not be same. Could we find differences among cells from different parts of the plant body? So they are asking that. So plant body is nothing but what? Plant is having branches, stem, okay, leaf, and root, okay, fruit. So all these are having same cells. So the whole plant body is of same cell? No. The leaf cells will be different. The fruit cells will be different. The branches cells will be different. That is nothing but the stem cells and the root cells, all cells will be having different. What similarities could we find? So, the only similar thing we can say that cells will be present in all the parts of the plant body and they perform their certain activities. They are having their particular activities to perform. Okay, let us go in deep so that you can understand it easily. So, some organisms can also have cells of different kinds, they are saying. So, from the activity, from these questions, we understood cells are of different shape, size, and they do different work also. It depicts some cells from the human body. So, they gave here some human cells here. Let us see. Smooth muscle cell is next. So, muscle cells, you're having muscles, right? So, these are the muscle cells, smooth muscle cells. And these are the blood cells. So, blood cell is nothing but the cells which are found in blood, or the blood is made up of blood cells. Nerve cell, so your body is having nerves, right? So this nerves are made up of this kind of cell. And ovum is nothing but the reproductive cell, we can say, and it is sperm, the male reproductive cell. This is the female reproductive cell and this is male reproductive cell. Sperm is male reproductive cell, ovum is female reproductive cell, and bone cell is in this shape. So your bones are made up of this kind of cells, fat cells. So body fat will be there, right? So these are the fat cells. So these are the different kinds of cells which are present in a human body. So the shape and size of the cells are related to specific function they perform. They are saying that the cells will be of different in structure and shape depending upon the function. Function, that means on which work they are doing, the shape will be dependent. Okay, some cells like amoeba have changing shapes. So you all learned about amoeba in your previous class, right? So amoeba is a single cell organism that is nothing but unicellular organism. Amoeba is a unicellular, uni means for single, cell, cellular cell. Okay, in some cases the cell shape could be more or less fixed and peculiar for a particular type of cell. For example, nerve cells have a typical shape. So typical shape is nothing but somewhat, see, if you go through the nerve cell here, it is very elongated cell and it is somewhat different from other cells, right? So here these will be connected, another cell will be connected like this. So in this way the nerve cells are connected to each other. Each living cell has a capacity to perform certain basic functions that are characteristic of all living forms. And here you have to remember that cells are made to function or to do some particular work. So what is the work of a teacher? To teach you. What is the work of student? To learn the things. So in this way the cells are also divided. Few cells are going to do one work and few cells are going to do other work. So that's the thing here. How does a living cell perform these basic functions, they are saying? They're asking that how all these functions are going to do, or how the cells are going to perform their particular work. We know that there is a division of labor in multicellular organisms such as human beings. This means that different parts of the human body perform different functions. So your body is having some body parts, right? So your heart, you are having heart, kidneys, liver, stomach. So all these organelles or parts are going to perform different activities, right? So stomach is meant for digesting the food. Heart is meant for, so here the human body has a heart to pump the blood, stomach to digest the food, and kidneys to filter the water. Okay, so these are the different parts. You are having to do different particular work. So the heart is not going to digest the food, or the stomach is not going to pump the blood. So particular organ is having particular thing to do or particular work to do. Okay, similarly division of labor is also seen within a single cell. So here we are, all the organs are made up of different cells, right? So if you go through the amoeba, what happens here, it is a single cell. You know that amoeba is a single cell, right? So in single cell all the activities are performed by, or all the work should be done by that single cell only, they are saying. In fact, each such cell has got certain specific components within it known as cell organelles. So they are saying that how this single cell is going to do work. So in single cell we are having some particular parts. Okay, so that parts are going to do certain works in a single cell organism. Okay, components means some specific things or some specific parts will be there in a cell, and they are called as what, organelles. So just for your understanding purpose, I am going to say one small thing. Okay, so how we are having hands to eat, legs to walk, and eyes to watch, ears to hear. So particular a thing is going to do particular work, right? In the same way, cell is also having some parts in it, so that the parts are going to do particular work. Okay, so this is not the basic thing. Just for your understanding purpose, I'm going to say like this. Okay, each kind of cell organelles performs a specific function. Okay, such as making a new material in a cell, clearing up the waste material from the cell, and so on. So they are saying that what is a particular work, making new material, that means reproduction. Okay, new material is nothing but making new material is nothing but reproduction. Clearing up the waste material is nothing but excretion. So all the reproduction, respiration, excretion, metabolism activities, all are done by a single cell here. A cell is able to live and perform all its functions because of these organelles. How the cell is going to live? Only because of the cell organelles the cell is going to live. Okay, how the work is done by the cell? only by the organelles. That means the parts which are present in the cell, if they work, then only the cell is going to live, or else it is going to be dead. These organelles together constitute the basic unit called as what? Cell. So cell with organelles, we are going to call it as what? Cell. It is interesting that all cells are found to have the same organelles, no matter what their function is or what organism they are forming. So in earlier classes, we have learned two types of cells, right? Unicellular and multicellular. Unicellular means one cell. Multicellular means many cells. So whatever the organism may be, it coming from the amoeba. Amoeba is a single cell organism, and we human beings are many celled organism, that is multicellular organisms. So they are saying that whatever the organism may be, or what, how many cells are will be there, all the cells are having same parts, okay? They are having same parts and they do the their particular function, okay? This is the point here. So they gave you a few questions, who discovered the cells and how. So this question you are going to answer or comment me in the comment box section, and I think you know the answer for these questions. Try to solve it. If you don't know, please comment me so that I can answer these questions also. Why is the cell called the structure and function unit of the life? So try to answer these two questions in the comment box. If you don't know, please comment me. I can answer you.